dawn, Chandigarh, May 31, 2008. 43-year-old Western Air Command Chief Pranab Kumar Barbora was about to break every rule in the book. The flight they were about to undertake had no written authorization because New Delhi had already rejected similar expeditions a total of 5 times. Just days earlier, Barbora had approached the then Air Chief Marshal Fali Homi Major and the Army Chief General Deepak Kapoor at Delhi's Air Force Golf Club.
Sir, I need at least your verbal okay to proceed.
It's a risky operation, Air Marshal. You know the drill, Barbora. If anything goes wrong, it's your ass on the line.
But Barbora had done his homework.
Sir, we have had the landing strip physically checked for cracks. I believe it will hold.
As the 5-member crew of 3 Air Force pilots, 1 navigator and a gunner set out in the early hours of that May morning, they were confident they could accomplish their mission.
We will do this. Jai Hind!
Their mission was to reactivate the world's highest ever landing ground, the Daulat Beg Oldi DBO airstrip at 16,614 feet above sea level. As they piloted their twin-engine AN-32 aircraft off the ground, they knew very well that this aircraft was not supposed to fly at over 14,000 feet. More than the landing, it was the takeoff that was tricky. What if one engine failed just as they cleared the dirt runway? Anything could go wrong. DBO's location is very critical to India. It is the northernmost Indian outpost, bordering the line of actual control, with Aksai Chin to its right. And to its left, the Siachen Glacier, Pakistan-occupied Kashmir, and Sakshgam, the area ceded by Pakistan to China. Lying just a few kilometers from the base of the Karakoram Pass, a major thoroughfare on the Silk Route connecting the West and the East since the 2nd century BCE, DBO has historically been a popular campsite for travelers and traders from India and Central Asia on their long journeys. Daulat Beg Oldi literally means Daulat Beg died, and is named after a man from Yarkand, China, present-day Xinjiang, who died on his journey through the Karakoram Pass. Ever since the late 1950s, Indian forces and the Indo-Tibetan Border Police (ITBP) have been stationed in Oldi. Braving flimsy housing, severe cold, lack of communication and poor approach roads, often forced to use a foot track which took them 3 to 4 days to cover on mules when seasonal floods from the Shayok River made the only other road unusable. Murgu is the nearest inhabited town lying to its south, with a small population of Baltis, who hail from Gilgit-Baltistan but are spread across Central Asia and primarily dependent on apricot farming and yak rearing. A few months before the 1962 Indochina War, Indian Army engineers built the advanced landing ground at DBO to keep a check on the Chinese occupation at Aksai Chin. But the landing strip could not be used much after C-82 Packet, a modified 3-engine aircraft capable of flying so high, was retired in 1965. This is where Air Chief Marshal Barbora successfully landed his aircraft around 9 a.m. on the morning of May 31, 2008. It was only then that the Defence Minister A.K. Antony was informed.
Good news, sir.
For several decades, while India has been busy with its internal conflicts in Jammu and Kashmir and the Pakistan border, China occupied Aksai Chin and began adding muscle to their border infrastructure. But when India tried to do the same, in April-May 2013, the Chinese occupied the Depsang Bulge area of the Daulat Beg Oldi sector. When the People's Liberation Army intruded 19 kilometers into Indian territory and conducted drills, leading to a 21-day standoff. The reason for the intrusion was seen as an effort to scare off India from constructing the motorable all-weather 255-kilometer-long DSDBO Darbuk-Shylock Daulat Beg Oldi Highway, running almost parallel to the LAC, a road that includes 37 bridges over ravines and rivers. Reducing travel time from Leh to Aksai Chin and the Karakoram Pass from 2 days to 6 hours. The DSDBO road would help India keep an eye on Gilgit-Baltistan, overlook the Hassan Abdal Highway that connects the China-Pakistan Economic Corridor CPEC to Kashgar, Sakshgam Valley, the 5,180 square kilometers of Indian territory in POK given by Pakistan to China in 1963, and the Siachen Glacier, providing Indian troops an alternative route to Leh, which so far could only be reached via Srinagar on the other side, and which Pakistan tried to take in Kargil so as to cut off India's sole accessway to the region. It will also help keep an eye on China's restive Xinjiang province, Tibet Autonomous Region, Aksai Chin, and the Tibet-Xinjiang highway that passes through it. The peace de resistance of the highway is undoubtedly the strategically important 1,400-foot-long Colonel Chewan Renchen Bridge at a height of 14,650 feet over the Shayok River. This 14.5-meter-wide bridge can take vehicles of up to 70 tons, giving Indian troops easy access to what is known as Subsector North, SSN. Sandwiched between the Karakoram and Chang Chenmo ranges, the location is not far from the junction of Shayok and Galwan rivers, which itself is only 5 kilometers from the LAC. Where the ridges of Galwan overlook the strategic DSDBO road and the main reason China wants to occupy these heights. On the west, Galwan Valley connects with Shayok through a road which is under construction, as are several feeder roads to DSDBO. While on the east, it gives access to the Aksai Chin Plateau, through which part of the Xinjiang-Tibet Highway passes. Aksai Chin, an extension of the dry plateau and not part of the Himalayas, has historically been part of Ladakh and British India since the mid-19th century. China, however, adamantly claims that it was part of various ancient and medieval Chinese empires. Through the 1950s, without much effort to stop them, India let China occupy the cold desert flatland that receives neither rain nor snow. So barren is it that on December 5, 1961, during a debate in the Rajya Sabha on whether to retain Aksai Chin or not, Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru,
"Not a blade of grass grows there."
But Mahavir Tyagi dramatically pointed to his own bald head to retort.
"So you mean I should treat this as useless? There is not a single hair on this head, but shall I surrender my head to the enemy?"
Forcing Nehru to backtrack and try reclaim Aksai Chin, leading to the 1962 Indochina War. So what could be the reason for this flare-up? China is now building infrastructure like a new airport in Tashkurgan, north of the Siachen Glacier and Karakoram Valley, through which the CPEC passes. Keeping an eye on the land of the three rivers, the Shayok, Galwan and Chang Chinmo areas, which are water-rich regions. The Sino-Pak axis is worried we may now try to get back some of the ceded areas or use it to disrupt the China-Pakistan economic corridor. Today, the DSDBO road and the DBO airstrip have added weight to India's bargaining power with China and play a critical role in multiple face-offs. India's initial breakthrough came after Western Air Command Chief Pranab Kumar Barbora reactivated DBO in 2008 by a successful, if bumpy, liftoff. A standby aircraft accompanied them to Thoise ALG, Advanced Landing Ground, one of the two others that are in the region. Since 2013, the four-engine aircraft C-130 Hercules has actively used the airstrip, and now the DSDBO road will make logistics easier. Depsang Bulge and Chumar 2013, Demchok 2014 and Doklam 2017 have shown that agreements to disengage and withdraw have a limited shelf life. Is China's desperation at India's growing military capability showing through and are seeking to change the status quo before it is too late? Biz Bo's Limerick. India built the strategic DSDBO road. With the Colonel Rinchin Bridge, our engineering abilities we showed. Now we can hold our ground, our borders safe and sound. The loss of 62 we can now safely erode. Subscribe to BizBo and click on the bell icon to get notified whenever BizBo releases a new video. Sources of all our information is listed in the video description section.